Most people already think gas is a ripoff. But when the meter's running, has it ever crossed your mind you might not be getting what you paid for? That's where Tom Corrier comes in. He's a standards inspector with the Department of Agriculture. He uses this testing kit to make sure pumps across the state are calibrated properly. So we asked him the question lots of consumers have.
When they pump a gallon of gas, are they getting a gallon of gas?
On the average, yes, sir.
But not all the time?
No, there's a possibility it could be off just a hair.
Just a hair, okay. So with gas in the mid-360s, how much is just a hair? The answer is probably not enough to make you want to pull yours out. The state allows pumps to be off by 6 cubic inches of fuel for every 5 gallons, or roughly 0.5% per gallon.
To put this state margin of error into perspective, we're basically talking about enough fuel to fill 2 of these for every 1 of these.
By today's prices, that difference equals roughly 30 cents on a 15-gallon fill-up. What the state doesn't allow is a pump that's dispensing fuel outside that margin of error, plus or minus 6 cubic inches. So when a test comes back like this, it's a problem. Top Supervisor Gerald Brown says he's seen some pumps that were off by more than 4 times the state threshold.
Years ago, I did find one that was around about 25 cubic inches. And that was right after initial setup or startup of the station. They had something to break in the dispenser at that time.
A pump that out of whack today would mean your final bill would be off almost $1.20 on the same 15-gallon fill-up. Interestingly, this pump, the one Tom measured at +7, wasn't ripping off customers. It was ripping off the station owner by giving away gas. That's why it's +7, not -7. The owner says he's glad Tom found the problem because his profit margins are so tight right now.
You're lucky to make 2 to 4 cents a gallon. If you're lucky.
The Ag Department says you'll be lucky to find a pump that's giving away gas. Gerald says 99 out of every 100 they test fall within that acceptable margin of error. And Tom and his colleagues try to test them every single year. Kenny Beck, WXII 12 News.